In Trenton, New Jersey on Sunday, police apprehended a 200-pound black bear that had accidentally wandered into the city. But you know something, Stu, in the year 2000, I'll bet you to this day, white bears can come and go as they want. It ain't right. Open up tonight by swimming like the man from Atlantis. Sorry, I joined a Patrick Duffy cult on Tuesday. Let's see what's new in the world this week. A federal judge ordered that Microsoft be split up into two separate companies. One company will produce the Windows operating system, and the second company will ensure that a bureaucratic travesty like this will never happen again by enslaving the planet with an invisible army of robotic mice. After threatening a sports writer, controversial Atlanta Braves pitcher John Rocker was dropped down to the minor leagues this week. Hey, that's not right, man. This guy's definitely a major league asshole. Just sparring, I'm building a little something here. And law enforcement officials in Kentucky are preparing to auction off thousands of handguns to raise money to buy bulletproof vests. You know, they're also selling their... AT&T announced on Tuesday that it will offer some of its cable TV subscribers access to a pornography channel. Well, that sounds great. You know, I'm on my leather couch, Dockers pulled down around my ankle. If I'd rather jerk off to the Sprint channel. That's what I do. Thank those of you who have one hand free for the applause. Israel's Secret Service has tightened security around Prime Minister Ehud Barak after hard-line Jewish settlers warned of violence if the Israeli-Palestinian peace talks move forward. You know, the Middle East is in really bad shape when peace is considered a threat to peace. Somewhere around midday, that appeared to be wise. I might have to reevaluate my lunch menu. According to a magazine devoted to the sport of cockfighting, it's a bi-weekly. Many, because you know there's not enough cockfighting moves to fill up a weekly magazine. Anyway, many cockfight handlers are giving their birds a form of speed before fixing cockfights. Is there nothing sacred left to believe in? How do I look down at my son at the cockfight? I'm sorry, son, that bird's juiced. Home Depot has announced that they will now start off with Brain in the orange apron, who didn't know that the difference between light bulbs and tulip bulbs is gonna be able to calculate amortization charts for a 10-year adjustable in his head. Hey, where do I sign up for that life-altering experience, huh? Yeah. Yeah, then I'll shift over and do some estate planning at Target. Mexico's ruling party attempted to lure female voters for the upcoming presidential election by staging a show featuring male strippers taking their clothes off before 150,000 residents of a poor Mexican neighborhood. And yet somehow it sounds so much more dignified than our system, doesn't it? And on Wednesday, leaders of New York's Liberal Party endorsed Hillary Clinton as their candidate for the U.S. Senate, calling her... So I guess quintessential means the opposite of what I think it means, huh? Sort of like Bill Gates is the quintessential homeless guy. Ah, Hillary. What can you say about Hillary Clinton that hasn't already been muttered under somebody else's breath? Now, I don't want to get off on a rant here, but love Hillary Clinton or hate her, you better get used to her, because like a retired Celine Dion, she's not going away anytime soon. You seen any still photos from Celine Dion's marriage thing? What a fucking freak show. It's like when Spock went back to fuck every 7 years or something. They're just crazy. She's crazy, her and that guy. Now, just retire, Celine. Go away. I like your singing. Just don't beat me over the fucking head with it. I just want to be a regular person thing through your publicist. Now, traditionally, the role of the First Lady has been maintaining an inviting atmosphere at the White House and then picking a special pet project to keep her occupied. Jackie Kennedy chose celebrating the arts, Lady Bird Johnson the environment, Hillary Clinton's pet project, total world domination. Look, I won't lie to you. This country has a deep fear and mistrust of strong, smart, accomplished, outspoken women, unless they're sexy 22-year-olds killing vampires on television. But what do we really know about Hillary Clinton, other than that she's had more makeovers than Sammy the Bull Gravano's wife? Well, for one thing, we know Hillary is an insanely, insanely loyal spouse. I don't understand how she can be in the same house as Bill without whacking him in the nuts with a polo mallet every time he falls asleep. But the, no doubt he digs that, too. But the Clintons are a rare breed. For many people, the idea of running for office, forcing the public to choose whether they like you or not, would be a nightmare. But Hillary and Bill need the assurance that 46% of the country loves them, and the other 54% is out to get them. That's why I'm different. I know all of you like me, right? Don't you? Put a new circuit breaker in the applause sign this time. Bill and Hillary possess that rare blend of grade A Machiavellian caginess combined with the luck of a two-time Powerball winner. Who but the Clintons could see one of their opponents bow out of a Senate race plagued by, of all things, charges of marital infidelity? I'm sure when reports about Giuliani's mistress surfaced, the Clintons laughed so hard they could almost hear each other from across the hall in their separate bedrooms. Now, critics have asked why Hillary chose to run in New York instead of Arkansas. You know, I think it has something to do with Arkansas being in Arkansas. But New York? Who does she think she's fooling? Hillary actually has to go on a listening tour to find out what the residents of New York want. You know, you can't spend 15 seconds with a New Yorker without discovering not only what he wants, but who he wants dead and when he was last operated on, okay? And believe it or not, New Yorkers are buying it. She's actually working her magic on a bunch of people who pride themselves on the fact that they cannot be snookered. I can only assume this is their karma for fucking the Indians over on that bead thing. I can't believe they cannot see how phony she is. Don't they see through those perfectly prepared speeches where every brittle smile has been pre-programmed to last exactly the right number of seconds to express humility without veering off into self-doubt? You know what I want out of Hillary Clinton? I want to see if she can tell me her home phone number, okay? I want her to tell me what's in her refrigerator or what her mailman's name is or when she last parallel parked a fucking car. I want her to tell me about the life she does lead rather than the life she thinks I should lead, okay? Anyway. Anyway, here's how I think it's going to play out, November and beyond. Hillary wins the Senate seat in New York. Now, you would think she wants Gore to be the next president, but she actually needs Bush to win. Then the Clinton machine starts a back-channel campaign attacking Bush for the next 4 years. Naturally, Bush is such a massive nitwit that he won't seal the deal for re-election in 2004, so Hillary runs against Dopey and becomes the great white female hope. Then we begin to think, if we can elect the son of a president, why the hell not the wife of a president? Next thing you know, Bill's back cruising trim in the West Wing without any of that bullshit running the country thing getting in the way. Plus, and this now gives the Clintons 8 years to get the 22nd Amendment repealed and get themselves sworn in as the fucking king and queen of America. Yeah, just you watch. Now, I generally don't subscribe to the grossly sexist theory that women who seek power are secretly compensating for something that's missing from their lives. But in Hillary's case, it's so pathetically obvious. I guarantee if Bill Clinton flies home this week from Europe, stops in Manhattan long enough to pick up a couple dozen long-stem roses, a bottle of Cristal, and a La Perla negligee, then heads up to Chappaqua, glides in through the front door, slaps little Francis Albert Sinatra on a CD player, picks Hillary up in his arms like he's Richard Gere and she's Deborah Winger in a paper mill, carries her up the stairs and spends the rest of the weekend showing her exactly what his definition of is, well, I think Rick Lazio will be running for the Senate unopposed, my friends. Of course, that's just my opinion. I could be wrong. Hi, pretty. Why don't you think, America? Give me a call, 1-800-522-8673. My guest tonight can shed some light on the Hillary few of us get to see, since addition to hosting his excellent nightly offering, The Daily Show and the Comedy Central, he toils as her trusty man-wench under the alias Candu the Wonder Clock. Please welcome John Stewart, ladies and gentlemen. John Stewart.
It was the check spot there, his office. And they dropped the checks in his bed.
Johnny,
what's happening?
You're doing great over there.
I'm enjoying
myself. Ratings are going up. You fit nicely into that nightly thing.
We're up to 80 people. Hmm? It's cable, baby. We're kicking ass.
80 people. Do you think one of them is Hillary Clinton? You think she watches guys like us to gauge?
She's all about the Playboy Channel. She's not. She is. I think like a lot of the country, and that she is. I think obviously a dirty, dirty little whore. And I think it's. She's a, you know,
what
I really
a great country, though, that you can come on and call the president's wife a dirty little whore.
Oh, I'm out of here. Believe me. I'm shipped out of here.
You are so audited up the ass, my friend.
The interesting thing is for me, Hillary's run for the Senate says to me, what a great country, what a great democracy, where even the most powerful woman in the world can run for office. I think that's really sweet. I think it's clearly, I don't know anything about her, but the truth is, I don't know anything about Senate. I don't know what they do. I know it in a grammar rock kind of way. I know, you know, I'm just a bill alone. But other than that, I have no idea what they do. I have no idea. I know this. I know there's 100 of them. I know there's 100 of them, and most of them are white dudes. But other than that, I have no idea what
old
they do.
Old white dudes. They look like the cats who outlawed dancing in Footloose.
That's exactly right. See, here's the thing. Look at the two longest-serving senators. I think it's Strom Thurmond and Edward Kennedy there. So who the fuck couldn't do that job? Do you know what I mean? Like, Strom Thurmond, do you realize, is third in line to be president. It goes Gore, Denny Hastert, and then Strom Thurmond.
Now, Denny Hastert was the kid who hosted Dance Fever?
That was. He was actually Eric Estrada's partner for many years, and then he went on to Dance Fever.
Remember when Denny Terrio left Dance Fever and Adrian Zemed came on?
That was the day the
Woo!
Music died.
Haven't seen.
I remember Don McLean writing a song about that very day. Awful day in American history.
I have not seen choreography that stiff since the Lee Harvey Oswald prison transfer. Now,
here's the thing. Hillary Clinton.
What's the thing, Johnny?
Here's the thing. Is, she's a dirty, dirty little whore.
You can't say that.
No,
now, does that get you off a little? Your thing to talk dirty about the first lady? You got a little stubby there, don't you?
I do have a little bit about her. There's something about powerful women. Her, Roseanne, I don't know. It's just something about her.
It just kind of, I just imagine myself just sitting by the pool going, let me have another Mai Tai, sweetie. I'll keep you going all weekend. You know, that kind of shit.
You're just laying there in a little tong, and Madeline Albright's got a frat paddle. She's whacking your ass with it.
How did this turn into this? What happened? I came out here to talk politics. It turns out to be a penthouse form letter to Eleanor Roosevelt. What happened?
Excuse me for leading you down the wrong path after you trip up with she's a dirty, dirty little girl. All of a sudden, I'm the bad guy. All right.
I came to teach.
Do you want Hillary to be your senator, or you could care?
I honestly could give a shit.
Yeah?
Yeah, because it's, you know, that Lazio's running a great campaign, though. First of all, he's called her a carpetbagger, which, what is this, Gone with the Wind? Like, who says carpetbagger? It's like saying, she's a rascal. She'll commit skullduggery, people. She'll give you the vapors. You know, it's the most... His whole campaign is, I'm a real New Yorker. I understand what real New Yorkers... Like, does being a native New Yorker make you a better candidate? Yeah, if you're Franklin Delano Roosevelt. No, if you're Joey Buttafuoco. Like, being from New York, you know what I mean? Like,
there's a wide spectrum.
There's a wide spectrum. There's literally people, hey, you know what I'm going to vote for? That Son of Sam guy. He killed a bunch of people. Yeah, but he's from Mineola. He's good people. You know what I mean? It doesn't matter where you're from. And I honestly don't know what they do. Lazio, though, ironically, is a lot like Clinton. He's young, he's handsome, he's witty. That's why I think Hillary, is just waiting to get fucked over in this election. She's just used to that
role,
kind of treatment. Yeah.
Have you met these two? I've never met Clinton. I had a chance to perform at that White House press correspondent thing. And I didn't want
you
to
didn't do it.
I thought I'd be full of shit doing it because I've said so many times I don't like him, and then I'm there standing next to him being palsy-wowsy.
I did it.
You know, I would like to meet the guy after he splits the presidency because he seems like a pretty cool guy to me.
All you got to do is head over to Shooters, that bar up on the I'll be there. Just head over there, I'll be throwing down a couple of daggers.
Yeah, I just don't want to meet him
Dennis,
when he's president.
Dennis, I got two whores in the back. You got to come with me, man.
He will be out here and hanging with David Spade within 2 weeks, huh? Him and Spade will be bird dogging.
Holy shit, Spade, where'd you get this limo, man? This is awesome. Check out these windows.
To rear Spade's line, he always says, when I see somebody in a limo, I go, ooh, you have $80.
Spade's the best.
Who's funny? But have you met these people?
I met them at the White House Correspondents' Dinner.
Yeah.
Because I thought the same thing. I thought, if I go down here, I'm going to be full of shit. And then I thought, oh, I am full of shit. I can go. That's easy.
See, you're more in touch with yourself than me.
I thought it'd be a great opportunity. He is crazy charismatic. You don't see her much. She doesn't. She kind of sits. She was wrapped in some sort of tribal gear because she'd just been on, you know, a fact-finding mission to Botswana. She had just come back. So she was wrapped in all the tribal shit. Or maybe they just keep her mummified. I don't know. She was wrapped up in all kinds of saris and shit. And he is the most incredibly charismatic, you know,
really?
Artist.
I can't imagine
that. He's like E.T., literally. Like, when he was talking
to me,
I'm like...
You mean the long middle finger?
Here's what happened. He healed me. No. I was blind. He touched me. I can see. He's like your height. When he talks to you, he was 5'7" for me. For my mom, he was 5 feet tall. It's crazy. He envelops you in this just tasty goodness. I wanted to blow him. Like, it's crazy. He's good. We're going to miss him. You think we're not going to miss him?
I think we probably will.
2 years of Bush or Gore, believe me, we'll be showing up at his house naked with a box of cigars going, stick it wherever you want. Just come back. Just come back. Believe me. We're going to miss this man.
Yeah. Well, he is smart. You got to give him that. And anybody, and these two guys do not look like brain surgeons. I mean, Gore seems at least like he's got electrocephalograph beating going. But
he though, it tries to inhabit whatever group he's speaking to. That's been Gore's.
Gore.
Because
give me an
he's
example.
Such a
what do you
blank slate. I saw him at Riverside Church in Harlem, which is about the most soulful place you can find. It's the epicenter of soul. And so he went up there and he thought, well, I can't be my normal wooden self. I got to blackify it. So he literally, you should have seen it. It was it was just like an acting experiment from, you know, Uta Hagen class. He goes up there and he's like, we can do this. Get out the vote. We can. And I literally, like, you expect him the next to, like, drive up to a synagogue and go, come on, people, we can do this. Come on. Everybody, we can get out the vote. You know, he's like a blank slate that just takes on whatever.
Why don't people call him on that? I'm always shocked that black people don't step up and go, what the fuck are you doing?
When was the
you're
last
like
time
Dave,
you saw
Dave Garraway, for Christ's sake. All of a sudden, you're Shaft.
That's what it is. He's like the in Terminator 2. He touches, and then he is. He can inhabit. But he doesn't, he's a bad actor. But that's why people are calling on him, because Clinton's the same actor, but he's good at it. He's a good actor. It's like when you see Sofia Coppola. She's a good director, but when you saw her in Godfather 3, you went, holy shit, what's that? You know what I mean? Clinton is a good actor. Gore is a shitty actor, so people don't like him. Bush, yeah, he's just reading prompter. He didn't know what the fuck is going on. Last time he remembered it, he was running the Texas Rangers.
Ain't nothing wrong with reading prompter, Johnny. We've got Jared in Baltimore. Jared.
Hey.
Hey, Jared.
Yes.
How's Heath and Barbara Stanwyck and Audra? Go ahead.
Okay, my question is, do you think that Hillary would dump Bill if she were elected president?
If she were elected president?
If she were elected president.
Oh, if she were the president, would she dump Bill Clinton?
No. At that point, she'd keep him around just to drive
you know
crazy.
What she would do? Here's what she would do. She'd do what Hugh Hefner does at the Playboy Mansion with the monkey. She'd tie him to a tree. She'd just out in the Rose Garden. He'd be just tied to a tree. And he'd go, he'd be like Fred Flintstone banging on the door. Let me in, sweetie. I love you. You're not there. She'd have just two Secret Service agents by the side of the bed. She'd be like, I'm lonely.
You are a naughty little whore.
I flew in.
I know, you're beat. I appreciate that, because I know you did Carnegie Hall, right?
The airline lost all my material.
Huh? They're brutal with it. They throw it around, you see it
jokes.
End up in Gallagher's hat.
I'll get it next week.
Thanks for coming out. John Stewart, ladies and gentlemen. Stick around. We'll do it again. Out of all the guys on TV, I find you the sharpest, Johnny. You make me laugh the most. You're always prepared. You take good care of yourself. And you're a dirty little whore. George W. Bush's idea of fun, shuffling his socks on the airplane carpet and touching minorities. Static electricity, Johnny. Moving on. Whenever he watches his brother George W. struggle through a press conference on TV, Florida Governor Jeb Bush fills out a request form searching for his real birth parents. A scant 3 weeks after declaring himself to be Hillary Clinton's challenger for the New York Senate seat, 42-year-old Congressman Rick Lazio is seen here begging Hillary to remove the curse and return him to his former self. And in Berlin, President Clinton finds that the Germans prefer their strippers a little on the heavy side for his taste. Yeah, make the check out to John McCain. So who am I endorsing today? Insiders say the bizarre casting decisions have virtually destroyed the possibility of success for the upcoming Charlie's Angels film. This week, the president of Montenegro had trouble concentrating on Madeleine Albright's words after he saw a regulation billiard ball roll out from under her skirt. Saw one of my best friends in the crowd. At a news conference on CBS Thursday morning, the remaining crew members from the latest space shuttle mission tell the press who they voted off the shuttle and why. Mark Dillard had found a niche for himself impersonating the Elvis Presley who was no longer handsome, but not yet fat. After consuming a whole bag of Cheetos, the Pope made a standing room only crowd of devotees wait while he licked every last morsel of cheesy goodness off his fingers. Florida Emergency Operations Center Director Joe Myers tells the residents to prepare for the hurricane season, and if they ever see this look on his face when he's on TV, to get the fuck out of Dodge. Everyone who had hired Tongo to paint their house said the same thing. Hard worker, bit of an attitude. And finally, you're gonna make it after all. This one, folks, that's the news. I'm out of here.